Hey, College Success, this is your video for week 12 already, which means we are just cruising through this semester at this point. So we are going to be continuing in chapter 5. So if we scroll down to where we need to be under, again, sorry about my week 11, the two parts, we're going to be in week 12. You can see we are continued from chapter 5. So week 11 videos will stay open for kind of a more full lecture description over the chapter 5 content, since I don't necessarily go in a lot of detail whenever we continue the chapter. But as like a very quick reminder, I still like to bring it up and just refresh your memory if you don't feel like you need a very full recap or a full overview of the chapter again. We'll just do like a real quick overview. So real briefly, chapter 5 started talking about like why do we take assessments, complete assignments, and it comes down to like those outcomes. We also talked about academic integrity and, what does that mean, being academically honest in your work and knowing the difference between plagiarism and cheating and how you can go about being more academically honest in your work. We also talked about the importance of citing sources. The video last week I went over where you can go to get help for citations and the role that that plays in being academically honest, as well as the difference between what paraphrasing is and what quoting is and what it's not. From there, we also talked about papers and presentations, the process of choosing a topic, and then also where that fits in the writing process and the bigger picture. In addition, some tips on revising, a little plug for the Writing Center, of course, making sure that you can utilize them for any of these parts of the writing process. And then the presentation, to combat anxiety when you want to be prepared and we want to practice. We talked about the golden rule and ways to engage the audience. It also went through, and even in the lecture from last week, I didn't spend tons of time on here, but these are mostly if you are using like a PowerPoint or a Prezi or Google Slides, something like that, whenever you do present. After that, it focused on some test-taking tips, like specifically for different modalities of tests. So again, for the full overview of that material, that textbook, go ahead and take a look back at week 11, because that video does go into more detail with the lecture. So for this week, you are completing the chapter 5 quiz and then the discussion, what are the steps in writing a paper? So it's tying back to that writing process component of the chapter. And then you'll see that final project step 5 video will be uploaded this week. So hopefully you have been looking at my other videos, and I'll talk about that here shortly. So let's go ahead and get into the assignment folder. So your discussion for this week, as I said, is ties next or back to the writing process. And this is due Wednesday the 14th for week 12 attendance. And of course, respond to two classmates by Sunday for the rest of your points. The prompt, and again, 250 words or more. I still am checking word count. If you're not very far off, I don't knock points off. But if you're considerably off, and by considerable, I mean like 25 to 50 or more, under the minimum there, I do take points off. So it basically, it's really simple, straightforward, what steps are involved in writing a paper. Now, the thing with this is you may have to kind of go into minute detail here. So you may have to really talk about, okay, I'm going to cover the topic, developing a topic. I'm going to talk about brainstorming, outlining, coming up with my thesis, fleshing out the details, organizing the body, revising, editing, citations, peer review, all of that. Like, you're going to have to go into detail to get it to 250 words, because you could summarize the writing process fairly quickly. I've seen it done quickly, and I've also seen it done where it is quite lengthy, even more than 250 words. But make sure you kind of hit all those key parts. So what steps are involved in writing a paper due by Wednesday for your week 12 attendance, responded to classmates by Sunday. The other assignment, again, hopefully to this point, we are very comfortable with our quizzes. You only have a few quizzes left this semester, which is hard to believe. It's already almost done. All right, so like a lot of your other quizzes, they set up kind of a scenario like this one. Ben is worried about committing plagiarism unintentionally. What advice can you give him? When do you need to cite a source? So some of these do have multiple parts to the question. Look, this one, really make sure you pay attention whenever you have multiple parts. And then you'll see number four is almost a replication of your discussion post. So what I would recommend is look to see what you wrote for your discussion post and make it a little bit more brief, because you don't want to squeeze 250 words right in this here, but you might just like kind of, you know, funnel it down a little bit, because you already, depending on when you do this, you might have already done the work. So you just might want to funnel it down. I would not recommend copying and pasting, which you don't want to do that anyway, but because it's just going to be too lengthy for this particular answer. But you can certainly help yourself by looking to see how you wrote your discussion post and then, you know, cut some of that out and hit the key points. So again, like, look at these. They really set up these scenarios. They set them up. And you really need to make sure you're addressing each part of the question. So all of these have been covered either in the PowerPoint, in my video, in the chapter, or a combination of all those things. You know, compare and contrast take home, online and traditional. So we pulled up a lot of resources, you know, for week 11 when we introduced this. So go ahead and revisit that as needed to help you finish this quiz. And remember, 2 to 5 sentences per response, please, to make sure that you are covering everything. So as a quick recap, this week in Chapter 5 is continued from Week 11. You are turning in your Chapter 5 quiz by Sunday. Respond in your original post and your discussion by Wednesday for attendance, and then 2 classmates by Sunday. Real quickly, just as another reminder, your final project is due the last week of the semester. You hopefully have been paying attention to the fact that you have a folder full of your videos. So there's the project directions. Steps 1 and 2 have been uploaded and open. Steps 3 and 4 have been uploaded and open. Step 5 will be open soon. So please make sure that you have already viewed the first 2 videos before you view step 5. And then after that, even there's a review video before you get ready to turn that in. All right. Hope everyone has a great week. Talk to you later. Bye.